Vad tycker du om Zlatan då?
Zlatan, jävla fucking jävla diva. Ja. Jag säger bara så här. Finns fler bättre än han, alltså helt klart. Ja. Bara så ni vet.
And welcome back. And here I am again on this vlog by J-Vlog. And I'm sitting here with my friend, who is also from Sundbyberg.
Peace out.
In Sweden.
Yes.
And he knows very much about sports. And he's an expert on football.
Yeah.
Yeah, and in the United States, it's called soccer.
Yeah.
But he is no sucker. He's an expert.
Yeah.
So if you want to talk football, you talk to this guy right here. And he's going to present his view about the five greatest football players of all time.
Yeah.
And this is very interesting. Everyone has asked me on the street, when are you going to ask Hadar about his favorite football players? And finally, the time has arrived.
Yeah.
You will hear it straight from the man himself. He will tell you now.
Of course. I can tell you, number one, it's a secret, but wow. Number five I can tell you now.
Well, you can say that all five are secrets,
yeah,
right,
yeah.
Now.
Yeah, it's true.
We don't know.
Yeah, that's true.
So this is a very exciting moment. So I just say, well, first of all, when did you get interested in football? At what age?
Since I was 6 years old.
6 years old.
I played football since I was 7 years in a team.
Okay.
Until I was 20.
And how good were you?
I was good, really. But I stopped. I met a girl. I stopped playing. So, but I think if I would continue and if I have been more mature, I could be a really good player. I think so, really.
And what teams did you like to watch on the television?
Liverpool, Manchester United, Milan, Juventus. Not so much Spanish football when I was young.
Okay.
Spanish football is now, the last 10 years, I like very much.
Mm-hmm.
But it was much in England, I think, yeah.
Not Swedish football.
I must tell you something about Swedish football. It's the most boring football in all Europe. So, you know, I don't want to comment Swedish football because for me it's a joke.
All right. Yeah. That was some strong words.
Yeah.
So how about we just get into it?
No problem.
So we will go from five down to number one.
Yes.
It's going to be very exciting.
Yeah.
So we just start off with number five. And who do you have on your number five?
Number five is the Brazilian great player from the 70s and 80s, Zico.
Wow.
He was great. When I was a little kid, when he was famous, I was maybe 7 years old, eight, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, he was, you loved him when you see him with the football. He was fast, technique, did very nice things.
Mm-hmm.
When he had the ball, always something happened.
Okay.
So that's number five.
And he was part of the so-called Samba era. They call Brazilian football, it's like Samba football, they call it.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, he was, you can tell that, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so he was, 70s and 80s.
Yes.
Okay, great. That was a good start on this list. So let's just go down to the next one, which is number four. Who do you have on number four?
Also Brazilian, but much older player, but he was great. And you know, if I say Pelé, for that time he was great. He was really great. Big player, technique. Yeah, yeah. And all the people enjoyed when he had the ball. So I can say he was he had better technique than Zico. But yeah, Pelé really, yeah, great.
And also he had a great personality.
Pelé. Yeah, yeah, really.
And he was a charming guy.
Exactly.
And he did some commercials on TV, I remember that.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. The American's best guard, not leave home without it.
And he's been in Sweden, I think.
Yeah.
Lots of times, yeah, yeah, not just when he played in the 58.
Yeah, World but Cup. Was it really World Cup on 58? I was joking. You know what,
yeah,
I mean, brother.
I know what you mean. They made a mock documentary. They claim that it never happened,
yeah,
but it did happen.
But that's bullshit, because it happened.
Yes, but did you know someone who actually saw the championship in Sweden in 58?
Really don't know. I really don't know.
Okay.
Not somebody I know.
Okay. Because he was very young there.
Yeah, yeah.
Fico muito feliz por estar aqui na Suécia, onde eu tive a felicidade de ganhar a minha primeira Copa do Mundo e fazer o Brasil conhecido no mundo todo. Obrigado, Suécia.
All right, that was nice. So now we have the bronze, the silver, and the gold players. So we start with the bronze player at number 3.
Another Brazilian.
Wow.
Ronaldinho. It's like to watch him. Okay, I told you I liked to watch Pelé and Zico, but Ronaldinho was something special because you knew always when he gets the ball, you knew he will do something nice with it and beautiful. So really, he's a great Ronaldinho, great player for me. And I think he have won the World Cup with Brazil, one or two times.
So
I think so. Yeah, I think so.
So when was he at his peak? When was he at his very best? Was it in Barcelona when he played in FC Barcelona?
No, I think before.
Before, okay.
Yeah, but in Barcelona too. Okay. He was very big in Barcelona, very big.
And he was known for that. He always had a big smile when he
played. Exactly. He was always happy. That's what I liked with him. And he was friendly to the other players, and he was not bad to the other team, you know. He was always friendly, and he wanted a good relation.
Yes.
So I respect him very much for that, for his personality. And too.
And when he was playing, it seemed like almost like it wasn't serious to him. It was like a game.
Yeah, yeah.
Like he was playing around.
Yeah, yeah. He was having fun.
Having fun.
But he knew what he did. Don't forget that.
Yeah.
Great. Don't forget it.
Okay. So now we have just two left, and the excitement—you can feel it in the air.
I know
now.
That you know.
I know.
You have a feeling, everybody, what I'm going to tell you.
I think so, but you never know. But I think so.
I tell you like this, no more Brazilians,
okay,
but not far away.
Okay.
Argentina.
Number 2.
Number 1 Argentina, I tell you later, but number 2 Argentina is, and here is number 3, Diego Armando Maradona!
That's number 2.
This is different. I don't have to tell you why I like him.
Of course not.
That's the difference. So you know what I mean. We don't have to talk anymore. But number 1.
But first.
Yeah, yeah, sorry.
Don't say number 1. Yeah. I have to talk a little bit here.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Number 2. We all remember in 1986.
Yeah.
When he won the World Cup.
Yeah, yeah.
And you saw it on television.
Yeah, I saw it live.
And the match against England was a classic.
Yeah, yeah.
How did you feel when you saw him dribbling the ball?
You think you're dreaming. I mean, after the first two plays, yes, but it continues. It's magical. It's like, what did this really happen? And I saw it live. It was like so. It was a special moment. It was
it was.
Yeah, yeah, really. It was, yeah, yeah. I think everybody that saw that game live will never forget it.
I remember it too.
Did you saw it too live?
Yes.
You saw it,
yes,
yeah,
I
yeah,
did.
Yeah.
But were you disappointed when he used his hand?
Yeah, yeah, I was disappointed, really, because he didn't, it was the hand.
Mm. It was God's hand.
Yeah, that's bullshit. So.
Yes.
So,
but,
yeah.
But also, he's a very special person. He's very flamboyant, very...
yeah, yeah.
Little special.
He was a little... Sometimes I think he could be a little aggressive. If you compare him to Ronaldinho, if you understand what I mean.
Yes.
Ronaldinho was soft, happy all the time. Maradona was a little bit harder, I think. Hard person.
And much more interested in politics also.
Maradona. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And... yeah, you know what I mean.
Yeah, he had some,
yeah.
some personal problems.
Personal problems, exactly.
But that was
I don't
after,
think, yeah, yeah.
But that was after his career.
Yeah, yeah, that's true. No, he was, yeah, he was, I think he wanted maybe too much respect, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
That is a different, he wanted too much respect and... you can't have too much respect. You must give respect by yourself too first.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't. I think Ronaldinho. Everybody can see on him that he respect people. You know.
Mm-hmm.
But in Maradona, you. No, it's not the same. Mm-hmm. It was a little bit harder, tougher. I mean.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. That's what I think. So.
And as a trainer, was he good? You think?
Yeah. Yeah. It was okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, well, Maradona is the one that I remember the most from seeing him actually live on television. It was when I grew up also. So,
yeah.
So che prima delle partite non devi avere rapporti sessuali. Cosa ne pensi?
Ma io credo che 5 minuti prima della partita no, però 10 non c'è problema.
All right, so we have only one left, and...
I don't have to tell you, you know already.
I think I know, but you never...
It begins with an M, and it ends with an I.
The last name, yes.
Yeah.
But tell us the whole name.
Lionel Messi.
Yeah.
It's the same about him. But I have a story for you about him that maybe not many people know.
Tell us.
He had, when he was a kid, he couldn't grow up. He had a sickness. He had to eat medicine.
Mm-hmm.
But it was so expensive, the medicine.
Mm.
But Barcelona saw him like a kid playing, and they saw on him that he will be a big player.
Mm.
So they took him to the club. They have a club for children in Barcelona.
Mm-hmm.
And they paid the medicine to his parents so he could take the medicine and grow up. And what I like with Messi, he's a little short, but he's strong on his body. He's strong, really. I respect that. He's very short. But strong and yeah, he's tough too, but not on the same way like Maradona. I think Maradona, like I told you, he wanted more respect. But Messi, I don't think he thinks I must have respect. I think he just trying to be a good person too and a player, and yeah, he don't want so much. I think respect.
If Messi was taller, he would be even better, you think? Or
I don't sure about that. I have to tell you something. Good. Now you wake me up. I have to say something about these five persons, football players I talked about.
Yes.
Three of them observe.
Mm-hmm.
No, sorry. Four of them.
Mm-hmm.
Three or four of them are left.
Left foot. They are lefties.
Yeah, they are lefties. So that's.
But does that have anything to do with Messi's height?
No. He will. I think he. It's better for him to be short because he's faster. He can run faster. He doesn't weight so much, you know.
And Maradona was also short.
Yeah, that's true. For being a so small player, he's very strong, Messi. And that was Maradona too.
But I must ask you something, because there's a lot of people out there who's going to say, wait a minute, you know what Messi has never done in his whole career? He has never won the World Cup for Argentina. And some people will say, because of that reason, he should never be number one. Maradona, no. He won.
Yeah, I understand.
What do you say about that?
I understand what you mean, but tell you like this. Maradona won the World Cup, but Messi wins the World Cup every game, if you understand what I mean.
That's
my answer. He don't need to win the World Cup because everybody loves him, because he's a great player.
Mm-hmm.
The greatest of all the times.
Wow, the GOAT.
Yeah, yeah.
All right.
So well, that's my
Everyone in the top five is from South America.
Yes.
Brazil or Argentina.
Yeah, and I remember the referees too. Just joking.
But who's the greatest player ever from Europe, if you can name?
That's a good question. That's a good question. We have Zidane, mm-hmm. where he was a very good player. Marco van Basten.
Yes.
Ruud Gullit, mm-hmm. also from Netherlands.
Yes.
I know that you may be saying, why didn't he take Ronaldo from Portugal?
Mm-hmm.
But Ronaldo, fuck you. Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Okay.
Shit, Ronaldo got an attitude. He wants respect more than Maradona wanted. R-E-S-P-C-T, that's what it means to me. R-E-S-P-C-T. Okay. And he's like, no, I don't like him. No.
Who's the greatest Swedish player of all time, you think?
Good question. I know what you're gonna say.
No, I'm leaving it up to you. You're the expert, not me.
Yeah. No, I think it has been many good players from Sweden.
Okay.
But maybe they once haven't been so big in Europe, like Zlatan, of course. So it's a good player, but he got attitude too. I don't like his attitude, so.
Play 15 years, never seen referee in this shit country. Don't even deserve PG should be in this country.
But is Zlatan in the top 10 of all of all times?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great. And who's the greatest goalkeeper of all? Do you have a favorite?
Wow, that's I remember the Danish goalkeeper. What was his name? Shit, I forgot. He was playing in Manchester United. Schumacher, not Michael Schumacher.
Okay, I think
he was from Denmark.
I only remember Preben Elkjær.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, so that's it, brother.
Well, I have to thank you for your expertise here and your very exciting list.
No problem. Thank you for being here.
And what's your when it comes to your favorite sports? What's in second place? Good question.
It's a very good question. Shit, I haven't thought about that.
So it's just football for you?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
Do you have a favorite? Who's the greatest woman football player of all time? Do you have one?
Marta from Brazil, I think.
Okay.
She played in Sweden too, many years.
Mm.
I think she still plays in Sweden.
And the greatest team of all time? Do you have the greatest team of all time football?
Liverpool will always be in my heart.
Okay, so you think...
Since I was a little kid.
You think with your heart?
Yeah, yeah.
And who... the greatest... let's see. Yeah, it's still working. Country. That's what I mean. Team.
You mean that I like now, today?
No, which one is the greatest of all time? Like...
No, it's Brazil.
Brazil from the 70s?
Brazil, yeah. Spain, the last year Spain has been very good.
Mm-hmm.
Germany, we can't forget Germany, they are great. But it wasn't so good this World Cup that was in Russia, but they have been very strong, the Germans, every World Cup, I think, since the 70s. And Lothar Matthäus, I forgot him, he was a really good player too from Europe, German player.
And who's your favorite Swedish team that you root for, that you want them to win?
Hammarby.
Hammarby,
yeah.
All right.
They play, okay, I told you that I don't like Swedish football, but when Hammarby play their best, they play un-Swedish football. They play football that I like, technical and fast, not long balls, high balls, you know.
All right. Well... With that, I gotta say thank you for your list.
Thank you, no problem.
It was a pleasure.
Yeah, no problem. Where is the beer? I want the beer.
It comes later.
Comes later, okay.
And in 2 days, it's Christmas Eve.
Yeah.
So I say
peace.
Merry Christmas.
And a Happy New Year. Take care.
Yes.
Don't play too much football.
Listen to this man. He's the expert.
Yeah.
Peace out.
Hello. We're in Greece. We're gonna play some soccer.
Det är en tjej som sjunger Michael Jackson.
En snabb analys av experten.
De första 10 som jag sa.
I den sista matchen ska jag vara lagkapten.
Åh, bra. De var inte sig själva i början på matchen. Sen kom de igen, det såg du ju själv. De låg under med 2-0, sen blev det 2 lika. Jag tycker de borde ha vunnit med 4-3.
De tog ledningen också.
Ja, de tog ledningen, precis. Bra match. Det betyder att de inte ger upp också. De är fighters liksom.
Ja, de är tigrar.
De är tigrar.
Som Paolo.
Precis.
Och nu ska du åka hem.
Va?
Nu ska du
dra härifrån. Ja, jag ska åka hem. Jag ska på kräftskivan hos grannarna.
Okej.
Okay. Det ska bli kul faktiskt.
Det tyckte du var viktigare än det här. Kevin?
Va?
Hej.
Vad tycker du om matchen?
Bra.
Ja. Jag ska våga gå på lite mer. Spring, ta bollen, våga till bollen.
Men jag gör det. Jag gör det.
Ska du ha din 6 poäng?
Nej.
Ändra mer. Det var jättebra.
Jag
berätta
det. Jag är där, jag ska inte ens hjälpa till. Så måste jag vara där.
Ja, fast ibland måste du hjälpa till, Kevin. Det är så, ibland. Exakt, det var det du gjorde det. Precis, precis.
Jättebra, du var jätteduktig. Kom, nu ska gå dit och samla där borta. Resten. Ta med den, ta med den!
Hur känner du som farsa till Kevin? Ska jag filma dig eller?
Nej,
eller vill du stå bakom kameran för att du ser alla ful eller?
Jag har inte fixat till mitt hår idag.
You're a hider.
Ja. Thank you.
Nej, men som sagt, de förlorade.
Men
de kämpade jättebra. hade lite otur. Jag tror att faktiskt... Jag tror de kommer vinna nästa match. Det här var kanske lite som en uppvärmning. Nu har de kommit in i kuppen och känt av lite. Liksom.
Men jobbar du på Viasat eller?
Ja, Viasat fotboll.
Okej. Okay. Ja, är du en gammal avdankad förbundskapten?
Alkoholiserad förbundskapten. Jag har med mig lite öl här borta om du vill kan du komma. Nej.
Bra miljö.
Ja, det skulle fan vara gott med iskall öl alltså.
Men du är trött.
Lättöl eller så.
Ja. Sånt kör jag inte med. Vi återkommer.
Det är en timme till här.
Bra, bra. Det är den här
sättet som var handig. Nej, 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 nej.
Lägg.
Vi kan start. Söndags förmiddag. Hader, analys.
Det här kommer från hjärtat. Helene Lund spelade skitbra. Kämpade. Tog vara på sina, vad heter det, chanser. Gjorde mål. Mm. Men framförallt kämpade verkligen. De var värda att vinna det här.
Ja. Det var, kan man säga att det var en liten målfest också.
Ja, 4-3. Ja, det var helt klart. 7 mål är inte dåligt. Nej. Det är kul alltså när det blir så där. Men det som du sa också, det kan ju hända vad som helst liksom. Så att, men de hade, hur säger man, de hade kontroll till sista minuten så att säga. Det är bra. Ja. Det är bra.
Vad har du för meriter som expertanalytiker? Du jobbar på Kanal Plus för.
Jag har gått över till TV1000 faktiskt. Men... Ja, jag kan inte säga varför.
Ja.
Så du vet.
Jag återkommer. Vi ska se om vi hittar någon från publiken här, kanske väl. Du ser inte ut publik, va?
Johan Nilsson, vad är du här? Har du varit här hela tiden?
Ja.
Va? Min son spelar, vet du vem Kevin är?
Nej.
Min son, han spelar.
Jaha.
Han gjorde 9 mål. Fast han torskade ändå alla matcher. Peace, bra.
Ja. Och det är din analys, tack. Tack. Se vad publiken säger.
Hej,
vad säger publiken om matchen?
Peace.
Analys.
Vill du ha smörgås?
Nej, analys.
Analys. Jag trodde de skulle vända faktiskt, men tyvärr gjorde de inte det.
Nej.
De kämpade i alla fall, men det andra laget var lite bättre. Eller de tog vara på sina chanser mer, kan man väl säga så.
Ja,
ja, det var allt för mig.
Johan, har du något termos med det? Med vatten eller något sånt där?
Ja. Kevin har vatten.
Ta en macka så du får energi och plåta.
Vad tyckte du om matchen?
Alltså det var roligt att spela med plåta.
Okej, tack. Ja, vad tycker publiken om... jag vet inte vem du heter, men...
Ja.
Har du biljett? Får se din biljett, tack. Har du betalat för att komma in hit?
Vad är min medicin? Shit, man!
Ja.
Johan, får jag filma dig då? Nu vill jag filma han som har filmat allting.
Jag är hemlig.
Fast han är ful och allting, men han får filmas ändå. Ja, ja. Fan vad är det? Shit. Och här är vi arga.
Okej, Hader.
Ja.
En snabb analys av matchen.
Jag är jättenöjd med Helene Lund. De kämpar bra. Målen var bara otur. Kevin framförallt, mycket fina räddningar. Han räddade kanske 2-3 skott alltså, som kunde ha blivit mål om inte han hade räddat dem. Jag säger peace.
Okej.
Okay. Johan, är det korv och läst som gäller eller?
Redan.
Ja, man är lite sugen.
Vi återkommer. Hej. kommentar.
Tyvärr förlorar de ju. Men jag tycker de var värda att få oavgjort i alla fall. Ja. Men de vinner säkert nästa match. De får lära sig av misstagen. De passar lite farligt där bak i offensiv eller i defensiv. Där framme är de jätteduktiga, men lite för hårda passar ibland. Jag tänker på att inte passa så hårt. Och så där. Det var bara det jag ville säga.
Där har ni Viasats expertkommentator.
Läs den, måste ringa frugan här nu, ursäkta. Det gick ju ganska bra då.
Ja, det gick bra alltså.